Hello everyone. So today's video is about how I am planning to restore the Shaolin. So like you can see, it is almost dismantled. So I took apart all the panels which I had fixed yesterday. So I'm going to talk about my approach on restoration, and we'll talk about how we plan a restoration. Okay. All right. So when I plan a restoration, I basically look at three aspects. One is things which needs restoration. Second is things which needs replacement. Third is things which needs upgradation. So to give you an example of an upgradation is, let's say, you know, there is the front end. So if I'm upgrading that to, let's say, a disc brake, so that would be an upgradation. Other than that, let's say if I'm changing the headlight dome to a more powerful one, that is going to be an upgradation. So that is how everything is planned. So let's start from the front of the bike. So that is how I start planning it. So first things first, the first thing that you see is the tire. The tire is as old as the bike, so almost 20 years old. So that has to definitely go. So we'll change the tires. The rims are not that great, so we'll change the rims as well. The spokes also is something that we will change. The hub and the brake plate is something that we will restore. We will look at the hub. I have some more hubs lying in the stock, so if there is something wrong with the hub, let's say if, you know, there is a groove inside which will impact the performance of the brakes, I'll change it. Then what we will do is we will rebuild the fork completely. We will give the outer tubes for buffing. Inner tubes we'll buy brand new. Then all the brake shoes we'll buy brand new. All the cables we will change. So that is almost the lower part of the front end. Also, we will change all the bearings inside if they are bad. If they are not bad, we will let them be, because this bike is not something that would need a bearing change immediately. Like if there is a play or if there is noise, that's when you change it. Another thing is, this is you know, a road to superbike series, so we'll try to keep the cost to minimum, but of course we won't cut unnecessary corners. We'll restore the front number plate, because this kind of a number plate is not available that easily. But let's see, I have seen some people selling it for 300 rupees for front and back. If we find those, then definitely yes, we will buy new. Then we have these headlight stay, these will be restored. The lower T-stem, the T-stem and the upper T-panel will be restored. These will be sprayed black. All these four nuts, bolts, will be chromed. These two will be chromed, plus we have one here, this will be chromed. I'll also give the handle for chroming, because you won't get original handles anymore. Then we will replace the brake lever and clutch lever. All the cables I have already spoken about. We'll replace, we'll buy four new indicators. Headlight dome is something that we will replace. Now, you might have noticed that there is a big gap here, so something very important is missing. So Shogun came with one type of meter, but Shaolin actually came with two type of meters. One was the one that came in the Shogun. So the last Shaolin that you might have seen had that kind of a meter. So the deciding factor to find out whether that is the kind of meter in it is to see if, you know, the interior or there is provision for gear change indicator. If that is there, then we'll have to buy that meter. And this meter is quite expensive. This is about 7,000 rupees today. So we'll see. If that is not the case, if doesn't have a gear shift lever or gear shift indicator, then what I will do is I will use an old Shogun meter which I have with me. So that is the plan about the front end. Then we will look at the wiring. If there is too many splices, if it is cut at multiple places, then of course we'll change the wiring. Otherwise we are not going to touch the wiring. The chassis, of course, it needs a respray. It doesn't need powder coating because the entire powder coating is not gone. Only in places like this there is some surface rust. So factory, I have learned it the very hard way, that factory powder coating is something that you need to retain. If you do not retain that, then there is a chance that the new powder coating will start flaking pretty soon. So I'll retain that. I'll keep the ignition coil as it is because this is working. We have fixed the CDI yesterday, so we'll go to that side and speak. We'll first cover this side. So as you can see, the torque bottle or the power box, whatever people like to call it, it is in fairly good condition. So we are not going to change that. We are not going to change the manifold. Carburetor we will service, and if the jets have any kind of issue, we will replace them. Otherwise we'll keep the jets. We will change or buy almost all the rubber parts. Then this oil, 2T oil tank is in fairly new condition, so we are not going to change that. We are not going to change the oil switch. We are definitely going to get a new battery. Then these two items would be painted. We will paint this. I am going to retain this rubber because I have not seen this rubber in the recent times. I have a new tail lamp lying over there near the tank, so I'll use that tail lamp. Rear number plate will be restored. I'll keep both the inner and outer mudguards. So we will keep this one as well as that one. Not going to change that. Then I have a new reflector, so I'm changing that reflector. This is available these days, so I'll buy a new one and replace that. Then this will be restored. We will change all the both the front and back footrest. We will paint it before we change it. Brake lever we'll buy new. Main stand we will buy new. Side stand we will buy new. The swing arm will be restored. We will restore the this rod which actually holds this plate. Then we will buy new brake rod. We will restore the brake cam and the this thing, and then we will restore both the chain adjusters. We will restore the axle. You might have seen there is a chamber here, but we are not going to put this. We'll buy a Shogun Shaolin silencer and we will try to fix that. Both the shocks will be replaced. All electricals, bulbs, everything will be replaced. Now let's go on to this side. So we will see if the RR unit is functioning well. If it is not, we will replace this. New spark plugs, of course. Then we will retain both the manifold and the hose because they are not available. We'll change the petrol filter. I've spoken about the cables, of course. Then we will change the element in the air filter. If you notice, this is something that I've noticed for the first time. So blue Shaolin has a blue accent inside the air filter. So that is something really nice that I have been able to see. Then we will keep the same toolbox. This is something which is not available these days, so we will not change that. We will give these nuts for chrome, all four of them. Sari guard will actually go for that will be painted. And this is something that I'm seeing for the first time. You know, the other Shaolin that I repaired didn't have this thing here for the sari guard, so that is an interesting find. You know, the funny thing is each of the Suzuki bike is different. Like, you know, you cannot say that they are same. We'll buy a new one of this. I would request you guys to give me a lead if you can find one of these. We need this. We'll paint this. We'll paint the cylinder, we'll paint the head, we'll buy a new gear lever. Stands I've spoken about foot pegs, etc. We'll restore the engine completely. There is a slight crank noise that I've noticed, so I'll see if there is play in the crank. We'll rebuild the crank. If it is not, then we will be lucky. We will get away with replacing just the bearings. So all the bearings will be replaced. I'll check the piston. If the piston has clearance issues, we'll rebore the vehicle to the next oversize. Clutch plates, oil, everything we'll change. Both the brakes, which is front and back, we'll change. Rear tire, rim and hub, that is something we'll change. So basically this is how, you know, I mentally make a list of things that is needed, both brake shoes. And then what I do is, once I dismantle everything, I actually use a box like that. I have actually three boxes. I need one more, because if you notice there is a lot of junk lying there. I usually, you know, use a box like that to put all the stuff in. When I undo everything, then what I do is I keep all the nuts and bolts together and give all those for zinc dipping. And there are things which needs plating, like, you know, these bolts, this, the handle. So those things I will give for plating. So the plating, the amount of plating is pretty minimal in this bike. There's not many things that needs to be plated. So this is going to be a full frame of restoration. I'll remove everything and then I'll restore. That is the plan. So hopefully tomorrow I'll dismantle this bike. Yes, very important, I forgot, needs a new lock set. So that is another thing that we need to buy, which I forgot to tell in the Malayalam video. So yeah, that is pretty much it. Center case, I'm not going to sandblast it or I'm going to do anything funky with it. I'm just going to clean it nicely with a brake cleaner. So that should take care of that. Of course, grease all the, you know, joints, swing arm bushes, everything. So that is the plan. We'll see you guys in the next video. I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope you noticed that this video is pretty stable than the previous videos that I have shot. That is because I'm using a new toy, and since the phone also supports Zoom, you are able to see part of that toy. Now you cannot, because I put this on the normal Zoom. This is the wide angle. Let me show you. Yep. So now you can see part of that toy. And also, that doesn't mean that I need to keep it at a fixed zoom angle. I can actually choose something between. I can zoom in. So yeah, this new toy is definitely handy. You can see it is pretty stable. It doesn't move much. So I bought this toy about 2 years ago, but never used it actually. So now I'm going to use it more, and of course I need to clean all that junk. So please don't give me a hard time in the comments saying that you have a dirty garage. I know I have a dirty garage. So yes, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, like, share and subscribe, and we'll catch you in the next one. Bye bye.